Good morning, friends. Again, Professor Shivayogi Patil here. I am also a trainer and coach. So today, I wanted to tell you a small story, which will give you insight into some important insight it will give you. So you might have heard this story many times, maybe your elders in your house, or maybe from father or your teacher might have told about this. So I am telling it in a different perspective. So once there was a flood in a village. The pandit of the village was traveling in a boat, moving from his house to a safe place. Along with them, there will be 4 or 5 people, including the boatman. There will be 4 or 5 people. This pandit was very, what you call it, as a having a lot of attitude about his panditya, about his knowledge. So he was very proud of his knowledge, something like that. He was someone who has read all Vedas, Vedantas, all whatever is there in the Hindu religion. So the boat was moving. So suddenly the pandit he wanted to show his knowledge. He wanted to, because he has a tendency to downgrade other people and show his superiority. So he asked one person, so how much you have learned? What is your educational qualification? So he told something like, I'm SSLC. Have you read that Veda? No, sir, I am not. Okay, sorry. Your 25% of your life has been wasted. So it is something like this. So that man, since was a pandit, he didn't argue. He kept quiet. Then he asked the second person, what is your qualification? He said, yeah, he is a graduate. Okay, have you read Rig Veda? This is the question of the pandita. Again, as expected, that person, no sir, I am not read. Then this pandit with again that arrogance said, whatever may be the degree you might have had, so all your degree is wasted. 50% of your life is wasted since you don't know the Rig Veda. Then he asked the third person, what is your qualification? Sir, I am a PG, I'm a M.Tech graduate, something, yes. Have you read Atharvana Veda? So he asked. So that's with the same arrogance. Naturally, nowadays people would not have read all those things. So he again, with a small voice, no sir, I haven't. Again, with the same kind of arrogance, the pandit said, okay, your PG is wasted. Your 75% of life is wasted because you haven't read our history. You haven't read our Vedas and all. You people are waste bodies, something like this. So the boatman was observing all these things. Then suddenly he asked a question to Pandit. Panditji, kya aapko swimming aata hai? Panditji, do you know swimming? Pandit said, what type of question it is? How can I? No, I don't know swimming. What is the necessity of knowing swimming? I don't know swimming, something like that. Then that boatman said, Panditji, all your 100% life is wasted, no? Because we are facing, the boat has developed a big hole and the water is entering, and any time it may sink. It may sink. So since you know this, so you don't know the swimming, so you are in danger now. I know swimming. And I think all these 3-4 people are also no swimming. We'll jump into the water. We'll swim and rescue ourselves. bye bye, said, he jumped into the water, and the boat sank, and the Pandit also got sunk. So what is the meaning of this? Whatever may be the education, whatever may be your education, you need to have some skills. Okay, swimming is just an example. It is one of the life skills. Swimming is just an example. It is one of the life skill. You can make it as a job also. There are jobs for good swimmers. But the moral of the story is everybody need to have a skill. Most of the people have. Everybody has some talent. Everybody has some skill. But they don't know how to monetize it. Monetizing means how to convert it into their passion and how to convert their passion into income. That is called monetizing. So if everyone has born with some unique talent, God has given everyone the same capability, same memory power, same thinking capability, same brain power, and some unique gift in the form of a talent or a skill. But most of the people never try to recognize their talent or skill. And even if they recognize, they will not be able to work upon it and improve it and use it in the day-to-day life or use it to make big in life. Maybe their family may not be supportive to for that particular skill. To use that particular passion or what you call talent or skill. But everybody has skill. Today, in today's world, skill is very, very important. And especially it is true for students also. See, in any general scenario, a person having skills will never be unemployed. For example, if you are constructing a house, try to call a carpenter, mistry. They are very difficult to get a good, it will be very difficult to get a good carpenter mistry who has done good works, good furnitures, good doors, good windows, something like that. It is very difficult. So skilled workers have always demand, whatever the skill may be. It may be a small skills like plumbing, electrician, carpentry, so wiring, so whatever may be the skill. So you have to work upon to that skill, and you have to build upon it, and you have to you can use it for your life, for a income generating opportunity. So for students, you also, when you are studying, converting your knowledge, you will get knowledge in your colleges. So converting your knowledge into skill by applying it for practical use is very, very important. So unless you convert your knowledge into skill, you have no value in the job market. And one more important thing I wanted to emphasize here. Today, the companies are least bothered about your college, your degrees and all. They want to check their skills. Already many companies, including Infosys, Wipro, Cognizant and all, whatever the top companies you can imagine, they have already announced, we are least bothered about the degrees, we are degree certificates, we are least bothered about the grades they get in the examinations. We are bothered only about the skills they have. If they have the skills to suit our job requirement, then we are appoint them. So actually, a study by NASSCOM, you might have heard about the NASSCOM. It is the governing body for all IT activities. So it was started as the company which produces antivirus and then which stops illegal copying of the software and all. So software related regular rules and regulation it will form. NASSCOM is a organization, big organization, which forms rules and regulations so that the softwares are copyrighted, softwares cannot be copied, something like that. But that NASSCOM every year conduct a study to know the situation of the IT and employment generation of the IT sector. So what they have predicted is, so 90% of the graduates who come out of engineering colleges or any IT colleges are unemployable. They have the knowledge but doesn't have the skill. See, earlier days, because I have seen it by own eyes, my friends who are not IT related, they were just BCom or BSc or something. They did some IT related courses like Java, the C, C++ was very popular then. Then they did Java also. And they got appointed in good companies with very high salaries. I was wondered then. They went for foreign also for projects. So I have seen that. So how that happened, even though they didn't have the necessary skills, but only knowledge was there. How that happened means earlier, these companies used to spend lakhs of rupees, crores of rupees for training because there were scarcity of graduates. In my college days, there were scarcity, especially it is in M.Tech days, there were scarcity of skilled IT people. So they used to appoint anybody who knows like C, C++, Java and other things, Oracle and other things. And they used to train so that they acquire the skills with a stipend. Then they used to take them in the payroll. But nowadays, due to recession and due to reducing margin of the softwares, so software companies are not making the kind of money what they used to make in the earlier days. Therefore, they have stopped that training. Okay, only few companies will definitely give the trainings for upgradation of the technology. But normally, they don't want to spend lakhs of rupees on employees just to improve their skills. They want people who already have the skills. Therefore, it is very important for any student to acquire skills. This applies not only for IT, it applies to all engineering branches like civil, mechanical, electrical, electronics, and even non-engineering branches like BCom, BSc, whatever is there, you need to have a skill. Then only you will survive in the tough competition. Because when you go to an interview, for example, non-technical students, I am telling you, if you go to an interview, so when you are playing an equal playing field, if you have a particular kind of skill, then you will have an edge over others. So when you are an edge over others, the probability of selection will be more for you. Therefore, my dear friend, so acquire a skill. So, it is very important. That's why I tell you, whether you are a non-technical graduate also, first decide where you want to join after the graduation. Then study the working culture of that organization or whatever you want, wherever you want to join, working culture. What skill they require? It is true for IT company also. If you want to join Infosys, you make a thorough study of Infosys working culture, what skills they expect from the candidates, and what kind of promotional or growth is there. So all these things you have to collect before attending the interview for the tech offering. So it is true for even non-IT graduates or non-technical graduates also. Wherever you want to go, you have to decide first, and you should know what are the skills you need to acquire to go there, to get appointed there. So suppose you want to become a CA and get appointed, then what are the skills you need? So of course, CA itself is a skill, but you need more skills to get appointed in big companies. So for that, you need to work with some big accountants, big CAs, and get experience and get skills of that type. So my dear friends, the sole purpose of this small video is to emphasize the importance of skill. So there is something called, we call it as ask, attitude, skill, and then knowledge comes. After attitude is first, what I have told you, attitude is, means your mindset. First, you always have a positive mindset. So your attitude, then comes the skill, then comes the knowledge. So we call it as ASK, ask. Always remember, ASK, ask means attitude, skill, and knowledge. Remember all these things, and according to that, you work upon yourself to generate those skills and to get that attitude. So regarding attitude, I'm going to release many other videos. So you will clearly come to know what kind of attitude you need to have to get absorbed in different domains. So with this, I'm concluding this small video. So if you like this video, share this video to your friends, as well as please subscribe to my channel so that you will get regular notification about my forthcoming videos. Thank you for your active listening. Thank you very much.